Students, welcome you all in today's session, that is of standard fourth. Now we are doing lesson regarding Windows, and I already told you about the taskbar. Now we will discuss the main elements of the taskbar, and the first element and first section, you can say, of taskbar is the start button. This is probably the most used button on the Windows desktop. When we click on the start button, a menu displaying the major options appearing. Look, students, I will show you with it in my screen. You can see here is the start button. When I click on it, many options will automatically open, right? Major options can be open, right? This menu, let me turn the page. Okay, known as the start menu. This menu, when I click on this start button, what is it? It is start menu, right, students? And after that button, notification area. This area is called notification area, in which we have antivirus program if we installed into inside the computer, then software updates. If any updation is there, then message will come in this. Then sound, speaker, this is the icon of it, speaker sound, right? Battery status, you can show the battery level like this, okay? How many percent of battery we have, we can know it about it. Date and time, this is date and time, like this, okay? So this is our notification area. Students, you always get some messages from WhatsApp or Messenger and any other softwares or apps nowadays. These all messages are called notifications. What is it? Notifications. And from computer side, whenever we get any message, that will also comes in notification area, that will display inside it, right? Next is quick launch bar. What is quick launch bar? The quick launch bar provides an easy and quick way to open program. This is the area between the start button and the notification area. This area from start button and from notification area. Ye jo sara area hai, it is called quick launch bar. If we want to open any program quickly, then we can open. Just like if I want to click on MS Word, then I will click on directly on this link and the MS Word will open like this, okay? So it gives us a quick view, quick open process from the quick launch bar, right? Next is customized desktop, customized taskbar. First of all, after that we will move on desktop. First of all, taskbar, how we can move taskbar and how we can change the setting of the taskbar. And for it, how we can do it? Whereas you have any blank space, you can use the area of the taskbar, just like here. Right click on it. Here you can write. Right click on it. After that, taskbar start menu properties dialog box will appear. Go on properties, click on it. Look, student, the same menu we have. This is the picture from the book and this is the actual picture. We have same window. From here, if you lock the taskbar, you can lock it, right? Or if you want to shift your taskbar, you can shift. Suppose this is left side, now left side. And if you apply, you can observe that the taskbar is on left side now. Can you observe? Yes, it is very easy to observe, right? Our taskbar was at the bottom of the page of the screen, but now it is at the left side. Now next, right side and apply. Now you can see it directly jumped to the right side. Next is top, apply. Now it is on top and it is lock as well, right? Again bottom, apply. It's again come back to the bottom. Now you can locate the taskbar on the screen any of one of four sides, right, students? Now beta, if you, what is the use of lock taskbar? If you lock taskbar and OK button, then you can't move it directly. Look, it is not moving. It is not moving anywhere. But if I unlock it, unlock, apply, and OK. Now I can move it anywhere. Like from blank space, I can move it left side. Look. Right, I can move it up and I can move it right side and I can move it again at bottom without the options. I can directly just click inside the blank area of the taskbar, hold it and move it to any direction of the desktop. It will move. Okay, so it is the purpose of lock taskbar. Now next, it auto hide the taskbar checkbox. What is the use of it? Go at the blank area, right click, go on property and click on auto hide taskbar. It is auto hide. Now apply, OK, apply and OK. Now look, students, when I go in the screen, the taskbar is disappear automatically hide ho gaya. When I move our cursor in the space of taskbar, the taskbar will automatically come up. Can you notice? When I come here, then taskbar disappear. When I go down, then taskbar automatically appears. This is the beauty of this option. Next is, this is auto. When I click on it and I apply, then the taskbar will permanently here. It will not move now. Next is, after that, yes, now next page, moving on next page, beta. Always combine hide levels. Always combine hide levels. What is it? It will pile up the icons for the same program and only show icons without their labels. Go at the blank space, properties, and it is, if we have options on the location screen, taskbar buttons. Always combine and hide levels. We have three options. Always combine hide levels. Combine when taskbar is full, never combine. So isme by default is never combine. But look, we have two zoom buttons. What will happen when I choose always combine hide levels and apply? Now you can see we have same buttons on together, on same location on together. Or when I click on it, it will open upside. When I can choose any one, look, right, in this way. Okay, students, now another option is combine when taskbar is full. It will combine automatically if taskbar is full. Look, here is no full taskbar, then Now this scene, in this scene we have full taskbar, then the data is combined, right? But when suppose I delete it, now it is different because we have space, then the data will, the icons will display differently, individually you can say, right? But if we open something, again you can see, if I open properties and again this page is occupied and again this is doubled, automatically doubled, right? So, and next is never combined. It will never combine and it will go at the end, no problem at all. So the best option is combined when taskbar is full, right? Or this one is also good. So apply it and okay. These are the three options of it. Now beta, icons. We have so many icons on that desktop. This is our desktop and we have so many icons on it. And how we will be identify, then what is the use of the icons of it of on desktop and what are the names of it. Let's move on the lesson. First is computer. Where is computer icon? You can see here, it is computer at the left hand side, upper side. This is computer. What is the use of it? Let's read. Computer gives you a view of available drives and their content stored on the computer system. When you double click on any drive icon, it display the files and the folder contains in drive. Isse hoga kya? Let's do it. When I double click on it, it will open, it will show all the drives, how many parts of your hard disk are there, C drive, D drive, then E drive, right students? Now you can see, if you want to see the what is inside C, then double click on it, it will show all the data. Okay, if you want to see what is in the D drive, double click on it, it will show all the data, all the folders and files. In the same way, next, E drive, it will also show. It means by double clicking, we can see everything. This is our my computer or computer. Next is application icons. These are the icons which you can directly open any file. Application icon, right? Just like it's a P for PowerPoint application. This is shortcut. This is the basic difference between application icons and shortcut, because shortcut has a arrow key at the lower left corner. This is the identification of it. It is a small arrow key. Let's see either we have any shortcut or not. Yes, we have shortcut of VLC player, Zoom, it has shortcut key. Internet Explorer, troubleshoot, it has also one shortcut key, right students? So these are our shortcut icons. Next is document icon. If you prepare any file in any format, suppose in MS Word, then you can directly store this, its link on the desktop. It is also very helpful to open direct the file. No need to search inside the Word program. You can directly open it from the desktop. If you have document icon, means ek chota rasta, aapka shortcut way jisko bol dete hain, that will be, that can be used with the help of document icons. Next is network. What is network? This is our network. If your computer is connected with a wire with another computer, then your network can be seen. Or if it is using any kind of internet connection, Wi-Fi connection, that will also see. Look, when I click on it, now look like this, my computer is not connected with any other computer, so there is no networking. Otherwise you will see the computer names inside this column, right? Or under this column, right student? This is network. Network means if our computer is attached with another computers. Okay, and finally recycle bin. This is the recycle bin. It is just like a dustbin in your room, in your home or in your room. Whatever we don't want, then we can delete, and the deleted file automatically comes in the recycle bin. Look, if I want to delete something from here, like meeting one, suppose this is the file and I want to delete. When I right click on it and choose delete button, then a message will come. You can see the message. Are you sure you want to move this file to the recycle bin? Means, क्या आप पक्का है आपको कि आप इसको मूव करना चाहते हैं? मूव मीन्स टू ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू मूव दिस फाइल, विच फाइल विच आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीट, राइट, विच फाइल, दिस फाइल टू द रिसाइकल बिन, बिकॉज देर इज अ फैसिलिटी इन आवर कंप्यूटर बेटा दैट इफ वी डिलीट समथिंग इट विल नेवर डिलीटेड परमानेंटली ऑन अ फर्स्ट स्टेप. फर्स्ट स्टेप में परमानेंट डिलीट नहीं होता है. इट विल गोज into the recycle bin, but deleted from the place where you want to delete. ठीक है, अब ये डेस्कटॉप पे एक मीटिंग वन नाम से फाइल है. आई चूज इट एंड चूज डिलीट एंड आई वॉन्ट, यस इट शुड बी ट्रांसफर टू द मूव टू द रिसाइकल बिन. आई क्लिक ओके. नाउ यू कैन सी फाइल इज डिलीटेड, बट वेयर इट इज इन रिसाइकल बिन. वेन यू डबल क्लिक ऑन इट, यू विल फाइंड दैट फाइल. हेयर इज अ फाइल, मीटिंग वन, द सेम फाइल इज देयर. You can understand beta. Now if you realize that you deleted file wrongly, that is not the file that you want to delete, you delete another file by mistake, then you can send it back. How? Click on it and restore this item. Click on it, restore this item, or right click on it, restore. Both options, from both options you can choose any one. Like click on it, just click on restore means to send back, restore this item, or click on it, right click, choose restore. Suppose I choose restore, the file is disappear from here, and close it, and you will find file on the same location. It will come automatically there, right? So these are our icons on desktop. Now customizing the desktop. How you can customize your desktop? Look students, the Windows 7 is quite flexible as it provides many options to change the setting of desktop according to your requirement. Let us try one of the options and change the color scheme of the computer screen. Let's change. First of all, right click in the blank area and personalize option. Okay, let's choose right click in blank area and choose personalize. We choose it, right? Again, after that, click on Windows color option located at the bottom of the window. Select any color to change color window border, start menu and taskbar. Let's move to the point, window color. Here we have window color, right? When you click on window color, you will have another option like this, and you can change the color of window. Red color, apply. Next, green color, apply. Look, you can see the colors. Ye dekho, you can see the also the green color here. If you want to change it, you can change. Suppose you want to choose pink color. Look, pink color is changed, and it will change in every window, not only desktop. It is desktop. If you want to change it in every window, then you can change according to the option. Malo, menus color is this one, and you want to change it in this, then apply. It is changed. then you can open any program. Then only you can change. If you have menus, icons, icon size. Look, I apply 40. Now you can see the size of icon. Size of icon is increased. If you want to reduce, suppose I put it on 30, apply. Now the size is reduced. You can observe it. Okay, beta. Okay, now size is reduced. Now, like this, you can change anything. You can change anything. So I am changing the color of desktop here again. And I want to take color, suppose dark blue. Yes. Other color you can also choose. If you want to make it a light blue, then okay. Apply. Now you can see everything is changed. Right, beta? These are the colors which you can change. As I told you, it is already changed. Now date and time. In the notification area, if your computer is displaying wrong date, wrong day, then you can change it from there. Click on it, change date and time, and according to it, change date and time. You can choose any year, any calendar, any time, and press on OK button. I am not changing because my computer is displaying everything OK. Right? Then OK. But you can change according to your requirement. OK. Now, next page. This is the photographs of it. Okay, let's take a quick look on it. We have already discussed about the how we can change the date and time. Use of shortcut menu. Shortcut menu, I told you that in a blank area of the desktop, you can right click on it. This is shortcut menu. It will always come after right click on anywhere, right? Then you can choose any value, just like personalize, gadget, screen resolution. These are different kinds of options which you can apply on your computer. And I hope you will try all one by one. Okay, students. Right click on the blank area of the desktop. After that, next page. I hope it is the last page. After it, yes, it's the last page. Right clicking on an icon. When you right click on any icon on the desktop, you will find an entirely different menu. The properties option will be found at the bottom of the list. When you click on any icon, just like it, when you click in blank area, then you will get so many options. But when you click on any icon, suppose I want to click on my computer, then the list is changed. But the main thing is we have property option at the end, right? Then this was your lesson. And from my side, it is completed now. Then I am going to take your attendance first. After that, I will unmute you. Okay, beta. Have a nice day. Stay at home. Stay safe. Okay.